We are under the lights this evening as we get you set for another edition of Baseball on the Show. A good matchup here for you tonight between the Philadelphia Phillies and the Arizona Diamondbacks. It's Diamondbacks Baseball on the Show, and it comes your way next. Madison Bumgarner, a lefty from North Carolina, gets the starting assignment. Dan Plesac, what's the word on him?
This guy's a pretty good pitcher, and I was looking through his stats, and one thing jumped out at me, a sub 1.20 whip coming into this start. That tells me a couple of things. One, he's not afraid to throw strikes, and two, when he does throw strikes, he throws quality, and he still gets people out. It'll be fun to watch this guy work in this one today.
Gene Segura standing in. He'll get us started in this one under the lights. Underway here in the Monday opener as the game's first pitch misses for ball one. Well, guys, you take a look at this Diamondbacks squad as they begin play here tonight. They've had it going the last 10 games. They're 7-3 over that stretch, including a win last time out.
Yeah, Matty, this is a nice one. First game of a homestand. You played well on the road. You got a chance to grab a shower and sleep in your own bed last night. I bet you this team comes out on the attack today.
Off-speed pitch in the dirt as he takes it for a ball. A very warm 85 degrees as we begin play tonight. Strike two called, and it's even at two.
That's a pitch he'd like to have back. You're not going to see very many pitches like that from a pitcher of this quality. I'm sure he'd like to have that one back to take a swing at it.
Here's the pitch on 2-2. Way inside with that one. Pretty easy take there.
Two pitch mix here. If you're in the batter's box, you're looking for something up. Sinker change up right here. Got to get it up.
Something has to give. Here's the payoff pitch. Shot to first, and there's one away.
Batting second, the third baseman, Justin Turner.
So one away here with the bases empty, and digging in at the plate will be Justin Turner. First pitch coming, here it is.
Ball, go.
So let's take a peek at our umpiring crew in this one. Behind the plate is Woody Keller.
You know, D-Row, Woody Keller's a good umpire, but at times the consistency kind of wavers a little bit. I'm not sure if you'd say he's a low ball umpire or a high ball umpire. Sometimes his zone changes from game to game.
Yeah, he can be a little inconsistent, Dan, no question about it, but he's approachable. As an offensive player, I just want to be able to turn around and say, is that as far as you're going today? And Woody will usually give you an answer.
Some guys are great low ball hitters, but most guys, especially guys with pop like this, they're hunting for the ball belt high and above. So that was a nicely spotted fastball down in the zone.
Two balls and two strikes now. And he lays off a pitch off the plate and high, 3-2.
To be honest with you, I'm a little bit more afraid of the guy on deck than the guy that's up right now. If I'm on the mound, I want this guy up right now. He's the guy that's got to beat me.
Bounce to first. And a step on first for the out, 3 unassisted.
Not a lot you can do with that pitch. That fastball just ate him up inside and gets the soft grounder for the out.
Ready now, Mark Withenshaw. First chance for him here in the top of the first with nobody on. And now pitch on the way.
Ball.
The 1-0. Misses for the second ball. Two out, nobody on. In there, 2-1.
2-1.
Now Now here's the pitch.
Great pitch right there. That is a huge breaking ball. Not shocked he took it. Got to calibrate that one for a second.
And that's low, so a good eye there as he works the count back full. Bryce Harper would be next. Bases are empty here with two men out. And we'll have the first base runner of the ball game here as that misses, and it's a two-out walk.
Man, you hate to give up a two-out walk to anybody, but especially to a speed demon like him. Good chance he's running here, and good luck trying to stop him.
Next to dig in will be Bryce Harper. And as you can tell easily from the splits, he's really struggled away from their home ballpark. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch.
You can bet he wants that one back at the plate right now. That's a pitch you normally see a guy drive if he has the right approach going.
One delivery. The pitch out. The throw. And they'll nail him at second on a brilliant call to pitch out, and the inning is over. Another look at the throw down that results in a third out on the bases. Back with more Monday Night Baseball following this. Zach Wheeler will be on the mound for the series opener. What do you have for us on him, Danny?
Hey, Matty D, we're getting a chance to look at a guy that's been like white hot. How about a whip under 1.00 in his last three starts? Not a lot of base runners, and that usually adds up to a lot of success. Let's see if he can continue to do that in this one here today.
So we're stepping in, Starling Marte. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. Now here's the pitch. In there for strike one, 0-1. These Phillies, as they enter play here tonight, fellas, they've had it going the last 10 games. They're 7-3 over that stretch, including a win last time out.
Yeah, Matty, I don't think this team can rest on its laurels right here. I know they've won 6 out of their last 9 ball games, but they come into this ballpark today, hostile environment. They're going to have to swing the bats early and get it going for the boys.
After 2 great pitches, he has a lot of options right now. He can bounce something or go elevated fastball.
One ball and 2 strikes to count. The 1-2.
Ball.
Fastball is right by him as he swings and misses for the first out of the inning.
Talk about blowing it by a guy. Jeez, I mean, that fastball was way behind him when the swing came through the zone. I have to think he was looking for something off speed, and he just couldn't pull the trigger on that fastball.
So now to the plate, David Peralta. As he'll take a tough pitch on the outside part of the plate for strike one. The average at 284 to begin play. 14 homers and 58 runs batted in. 0-1 count. Here's the pitch. And on 0-2, he misses with a fastball.
One ball.
Bases are empty. One man out. Fastball swung on and grounded out towards second. Forsythe has it. And there are 2 away now. The bases are empty here with 2 gone. And that will bring up Eduardo Escobar. Wheeler gets the sign. Here comes the first pitch. Fastball taken, but that gets the zone for a strike. Not close with that one. It's way above the strike zone. Now the 1-1 pitch. Misses. Ball two.
Pretty good pitch right there. Fastball in off the plate. One of the things you want to do as a pitcher, try to stand those hitters up.
Boy, he just threw that fastball by him.
Hey, I think this is going to be the key to his success out on the mound. That good movement on that two-seam fastball is going to keep that ball in the yard and keep this offense on its toes.
2-2. And it's fouled away. The 2-2 one more time. And he fouls this one off. Here now the 2-2. Doesn't get the zone. Count full now.
Hey, this guy's a hard guy to put away. He's fouling off some tough pitches. 2-2 count. And he just seems to keep hanging right in there.
This is skied into short left center. Center fielder coming on. Long run. Buddy gets there to track this one down. And a very nicely recorded out number 3. Diamondbacks down in order. And this is still a nothing-nothing ballgame. Second inning set to go, and that'll bring up Bryce Harper. He's ready. Here's the first offering. Check swing, but he held up in time. Ball one.
One ball, no strike.
And he lays off a fastball here that looked pretty good, but it's 2-0.
He may be down 2-0 after those first two pitches in this AB, but those are pitches he can feel pretty good about. They didn't miss by a whole lot, so it's not like he's all over the place.
Here's the pitch.
B-Rod. 2-1.
Two and two the count. Pitch on the way. Grounded to short. And that finds its way through for a base hit.
The pitcher got the result he was looking for. Change up down in his zone, gets him to hit it on the ground, but obviously the result wasn't what he wanted.
Andrew McCutcheon.
Here's Andrew McCutcheon now. So take a look at ball one. He comes in with that average down in the 240s. 14 homers and 34 driven in. Fastball that time that runs in a bit too tight, and it's 2-0 now.
You never want to fall behind as a pitcher, but doing it to a guy like this is even worse. He's got to bear down and execute for the rest of this at bat, starting right now.
Hit high and deep out to straightaway left. Peralta going back to the track. On the warning track, he makes the catch.
That is good. The first baseman, number 17, Reese Hoskins.
So striding forward for his first opportunity, Reese Hoskins. And he's been swinging it well the last couple of games. Second base.
Well, that's not a good look. No one likes getting picked off, but it's especially bad when it's your team's first hit. It's kind of deflating.
Infield in the overshift here. Now the pitch. In there at the letters 0-1. No score here as we play inning number two. Popped him up. Kelly is there. And that retires the shot. Down quickly go the Phillies. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score. Zone for a called strike.
Look at the radar gun on that slider. Off speed pitch, 91 miles an hour. That's just pure filth.
Lifted down the line and left. And that will end up a foul ball. Here comes Wheeler's 0-2.
Ball. We're playing two.
Turned on that one and crushed it. Just pulled it a little foul. Fouled away. Two one more time.
Ball.
You can certainly tell at bats like this one frustrate the heck out of the pitcher. But you got to find a way to stay composed and execute your plan.
And he takes ball four. Leadoff man's aboard here to begin the home half of the second. Here comes the first pitch.
Pitch like that to this guy, that's right where you want to miss. Any lower, and he'll probably make you pay for it.
Up top, it's 2-0. First with it is Wheeler. Throw is up the line as it gets away. And now, in fact, they'll tag him out at second base trying to advance on the bad throw. What a break there. Now the 2-0. Bottom of the second here with no score. Lifted into the air out towards center field. Withenshaw is there, two gone.
That
Sliding into the box, Carson Kelly. And as you check out his righty-lefty splits, no surprise that he hits better against southpaws than he does against right-handers. First offering on its way.
Ball.
The 1-0. That fastball was a lively one. You could hear the pop of the glove all the way up here.
Hey, I admit I'm a little biased. There's nothing better than that pop of a glove on a good fastball. Looking forward to hearing a lot more of that pop the rest of this one.
Can't keep the weight back, and he falls behind 1-2. Wheeler into his motion. Here's the pitch. 2-2 now. Two away, and the base is empty. Well above the letters with the fastball that time.
No pitcher likes to take the count to 3-2, especially when you throw a non-competitive pitch like that on 2-2. That one wasn't even close.
And he will get there to make the running play, and that will end the inning. Diamondbacks down without much of a fight. We'll move to the third with no score. Coming to the plate now, Logan Forsythe. He'll begin things here against Madison Bumgarner. First delivery to him on the way. There's a good fastball on the outside corner as he'll take a look at strike one. And here's a curveball in the dirt that time for a ball. 1-1. One and two.
I know that fastball registered at about 92, 93, but I guarantee you it looked about 4 to 5 miles an hour faster than that. For this offensive player, after coming off a curveball, the old push the throttle and pull it is being used.
The 1-2. It's laid off for ball two.
You know he's probably cheating on that inside pitch after he got jammed earlier. If you're on the mound right now, you want to try to hit that outside corner, and there's a pretty good chance you'll get him to roll over something.
Patience to hold back on the curveball in the dirt. It's full now, 3-2.
Well, that sets up a big pitch right here, Matt, because you don't want to lose the leadoff guy in a scoreless game. It's tough to work around the leadoff walk.
Into center field, line drive, base hit.
Batting it. Defensive. Yeah. Collins.
So next to the plate for the Phillies, Zach Collins. And he's just hoping for something to go his way in this one. And as you can see, it's not been the case of late. From the stretch. Right there for strike one.
Hey, I don't care what league you're in, American, National, you're playing on Mars. If you get a heater down the middle of the plate as an eight-hole hitter, you better be swinging the bat.
Takes a pitch high and away for ball one.
Playing 11.
Swing and a miss on the fastball, and it's 1-2.
I can't imagine he was sitting on fastball at his neck right there. He is going to have to lower his sights if he's going to have any chance.
Swing and a miss on the fastball, and that's the first out. Good job of making him chase a pitch for the strikeout there.
Yeah, Matt, that's the advantage of getting ahead in the count. You can really force hitters to expand their zone and protect. And when they're in that mode, getting them to go after a pitch they can't do much with becomes a lot easier.
And now, Zach Wheeler. And
Now a bunt attempt here as he gets this one down. But this is foul for the first strike. Here's the 0-1. And they'll try to stay out of the double play here as he lays this one down. One there. He'll put this in his pocket and be content with just a one out.
That was kind of a high degree of difficulty play that time. You see the off-balance throw to second base, and he couldn't get a lot on it, but they did get the out.
Back to the top of the order now, and that'll bring in the middle infielder, Gene Segura. Comes set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch. And boy, a high strike called there. That's not all that consistent, but it's strike one. Fastball, and he's quickly in the hole, 0-2. So far this year against southpaws, Segura is below the Mendoza line. Batting average under 200, unfortunately.
Matty, he struggled this season against left-handed pitching, but maybe a little shot of confidence with the manager putting him in the lineup.
The 1-2. He is swung on and missed. He got him. Philly strand one. Home half of the third coming up. No score. For the last half of the inning, and set to go is the second baseman, Wyatt Matheson. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Lifted in the air toward the line and right. Harper on the run, and he makes the catch in the corner. So the bases are empty with one man gone, and that means that Nick Ahmed will be the next to bat. Here comes the first pitch. That softly hit to right. Will that get down? Forsythe onto the grass. He gets there and makes the play for the second out of the inning.
Not enough.
Bases are empty here with two gone, and the pitcher Madison Bumgarner will bat next. Wheeler gets the sign. Here's the first pitch.
That's one of those pitches you just float over the plate. 99% of the time the batter is taking at least the first pitch after two straight one pitch out, so you almost can underhand it up there.
Waved at and missed for the third out. Not much of a chance at hitting that one, and the inning is over. So 1-2-3 go the Diamondbacks. We'll head to the fourth, still scoreless. New inning set to get underway, and that'll bring up the third baseman, Justin Turner.
This game is rolling right along as we move into the middle innings with no score. You'd think by now one of these two teams would be able to get some base runners on and get him in, but that hasn't been the case.
First pitch of the at bat. Fiftieth pitch of the game on its way.
No, that's the ball.
Won't go after the 2-1 sinker, and it's three balls and a strike now.
Good job to work the count and put himself back in the driver's seat. Started off with one strike, and now he's got the count in his favor, 3-1.
Fouled off. now the 3-2 pitch. Line drive to left. Peralta is there and he makes the catch for the out. So with one away, let's punch up the graphic and show you the pitch speed comparison for the two starters here in the fourth inning. And whoa, you see the big number. How about 99 for a top speed? Not too many guys around the league can match that. Stepping in and ready for another shot, Mark Withenshaw. He drew a walk his first time up. Now here it comes. And this pitch is taken on the inner half for strike one. Here's the pitch. Hit out towards second. Fielded cleanly. On to first, and Bumgarner's rolled him right through him here. Two away now.
The right fielder, number three, Bryce Harper.
And Bryce Harper will dig into the plate. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch.
No.
Harper doesn't usually enjoy left-handed pitching like this as much as he does at-bats against right-handers. I'm not sure if it's a comfort thing or if he just sees the ball better coming from the right side, but that's the book on him at this point in his career. 2-0 now. Now the pitch. 3-0 now.
I'd be shocked if this wasn't a four-pitch walk right here. He doesn't want to mess around and leave something over the heart of the plate and get beat in this situation.
That one's in there. 3-1.
You maybe get two pitches a game where all the guesswork goes out the window. This is certainly that situation.
No runs, two hits, and no errors on the ledger for the Phillies to this point. Lifted the other way down the left field line. After it is Peralta. And they can't run it down. The 3-2 pitch. And it's fouled away. The next 3-2. Swing and a miss as he chased with two strikes, and that will retire the side. Three up, three down for Philadelphia. On to the bottom of the fourth now, still with no score. Back with Mark DeRosa and Dan Brezak, Matt Bastergeon, as Starling Marte steps in to start out the inning. Baseman in tight, protecting the bunt, the first pitch. Soft grounder left side. He's got it. And that's out number one.
Now batting.
At the plate, David Peralta. He got on top of one and was a ground out victim last time. First pitch of the at bat.
Ball. 1-0.
Pitching has the upper hand early as we're scoreless in inning number four. Hit hard on the ground towards second. And the Diamondbacks have their first hit of the game.
Nice execution right there. Ball was down below the knees. He stayed through it. He was able to drive it for a base hit.
Here's Eduardo Escobar as he pops the first pitch foul behind the plate. Set to deliver the 0-1.
Ball one.
And that misses 1-1. Escobar, a 5'10" switch hitter. This is his 10th season at the major league level, so almost a decade, which is quite an accomplishment. Swing and a miss, and he's behind 1-2.
That front door slider is a devastating pitch. By the time you realize it's in the zone, it's too late. You can't even put a good swing on it.
Peralta, base runner at first with one out. To two balls and two strikes now. Weak roller right side. And the off-balance throw beats him at first, and that's a tough play.
Now batting.
Next will be the cleanup hitter, Christian Walker, who will face on balls his first time up. He set now the pitch.
Ball.
No runs, just one hit. No errors so far for the Diamondbacks. And he lays off a fastball here that looked pretty good, but it's 2-0.
Hey, you want to talk about being in the zone? This guy's been raking lately. It all starts with his pitch selection. Two great takes, and he's almost daring the pitcher. Just go ahead and challenge him.
The 2-0. Rounded weakly down the line toward third. But a foul ball, and it's 2-1 now. The set and the 2-1. Got him swinging on the splitter that time, and with that, the side is retired. One left for Arizona through four. Still tied, nothing. Welcome back. Heidi Watney standing by as we get set for the top of the fifth.
Matt, I talked with Philadelphia's manager during the break about the Phillies' offensive production to this point. And flat out, he was very pleased with the quality of their at-bats. Despite the fact that they've yet to push a run across, the game is still tied, and the pitch count for their opposition is really getting up there. They think that making him work as hard as he has is going to pay off later in the game, and that they just need to stick to the process.
All right, thanks, Heidi. So coming to the plate, Andrew McCutchen flied out in his first at-bat, so make him 0-1 so far.
That's a strike.
And a high strike there, 0-1.
No ball, one strike.
One and one to Andrew McCutchen. 1-1 now to McCutchen. Chop to third. Scooped up. And the fifth inning will start with a ground out, one away.
Now batting, the first baseman, Reese Hoskins.
So the base is empty here with one away. And that'll bring in a perennial MVP candidate for years to come, Reese Hoskins. First offering on its way. There's a strike at the knees, 0-1. One out, nobody on. One ball and one strike to the Phillies' first baseman. A ball and two strikes now.
Hey, I don't mind that tape right there. That was a nasty breaking ball. Started outside the zone, popped back inside the zone. Good spin rate on it. Move on to the next pitch.
And here is strike three called on the fastball. Looked to be about eye level, but it's out number two instead.
Well, that call looked like it was a little in the pitcher's favor, but it wasn't outrageous. Hey, listen, calling balls and strikes is a really tough job, and even the best are going to miss some from time to time, especially when they're sort of borderline like that last one. Not sure the hitter would want to hear that, though.
Standing in now, Logan Forsythe. Bumgarner gets ahead of him with strike one. A base hit in his first trip. Wind up and the 0-1. Hit well down the left field line, but back into the crowd foul. This should end the inning as it's sent out to second. Fielded cleanly. Throw in the dirt, but a good scoop at first saves an error as the side is retired. Phillies down in order. Halfway home, still no score. Welcome back for the bottom of the fifth. Here's Heidi Watney.
Well, Matt, I had a chance to talk about the state of the D-backs offense with their manager between innings. And he told me he's pretty unhappy with their discipline at the plate in this one. He said they've been chasing at pitches out of the zone all game, which obviously doesn't usually lead to good results. Until they start being more selective with their swings, he said they will continue to struggle.
Okay, thank you, Heidi. Digging in. We'll start things out in the home half of inning number five. First pitch of the at bat. Wind up and the 0-1. Swings through it for strike number two.
He hasn't thrown that pitch much all game. I got to believe as an offense, you just got to throw that pitch away and move on to the next one.
Ball and two strikes now. Ball and two strikes. Here's the pitch. Neither guy willing to give in, and the at bat will continue. And another foul ball. A 2-2 one more time.
Hey, this has been an epic at bat right here. I don't blame the pitcher for a little nibbling right there. Maybe get a swing and a miss. He didn't bite on that one, so now we go full count.
Locked in a good battle. Here comes another one. And he turns on one, sending it high and deep to right. Back goes Harper, and that one is. Straightaway right field, number 22 on the year, and the Diamondbacks strike first. It's 1-0.
Well, if you're going to give up a towering blast to one of the best players in their lineup, it's better to do it with no one on base. It stings, sure, but a solo shot isn't going to be a deciding factor in the game.
For one thus far. Bouncing to the left side. Throw on the first, so a good comeback there as he gets the first out of the inning.
Up next to the Diamondbacks, the second baseman, Wyatt Matheson.
So digging in now, Wyatt Matheson, one run in and one gone so far this inning. First delivery to him on the way. He'll hold off on the slider to start the at bat. It's ball one. And And he won't bite at that one either. It's 2-0.
Two balls, no strike.
Got a very undisciplined swing there. It's 2-1.
Not too many guys taking the mound today with this good a split. Look at the downward action on that thing. It's falling off the table.
No. And that misses up and in, 3-1. Hitters count all the way. Here it comes. High in the air and drifting out to shallow center. Withenshaw comes on now and makes the catch in shallow center for out number two.
The batter number 13, Nick Ahmed.
Ready for another chance? Nick Ahmed comes into this at bat 0-for-1 in the ballgame. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes.
Ball one.
The 1-0.
Ball. No. 2-1.
Both teams with just two hits apiece thus far. Three balls and a strike to count to the Diamondbacks shortstop.
3-1. Ball four.
Low ball four.
That's a nice job to work that walk right there. Even if it doesn't lead you anything on the scoreboard this inning, it prevents the pitcher from having to lead off in the next one. Just one of those small things that might go unnoticed, but in the end, make a big difference.
So a runner at first with two away, and the pitcher Madison Bumgarner will bat next. Wheeler pauses. Here it comes.
No.
Two out with the man at first. And wow, a very high strike, but a strike nonetheless, and it's 1-1. Jumpy there as he swings through the fastball. To first. Oh, and it eats him up a bit. Flips it behind his back. Throw on to first, gets him, and the side is retired. Diamondbacks hit the board first thanks to this solo home run. We're through five innings here tonight. It's now 1-0 Arizona. Stepping in, Zach Collins will start things out in the sixth for a lineup that really hasn't found its groove in this one.
Yeah, only two hits so far, Matt, and not very many hard hit balls either. We'll see if they can start making some adjustments.
First pitch coming, here it is. And a ball, 1-0. And he fouls this one off. Now the 1-1 pitch. And swung on and missed, and that's strike two. Curveball that's in the dirt that time, and it's back even now at 2-2. There's a swing and a missile sent out to center field. Marte going back. Oh, but it's off the balcony. coast into second with a leadoff double.
So up until this point, they've had to bite and scratch for every single thing, but he puts a good swing on this one and nearly knocks it out of the park. So we'll see if it's contagious and his partner can pick him up right here.
Into the box now, Zach Wheeler. And the first pitch to him runs a bit inside for ball one. 0 for 1 for him here in this one. And he'll try and get his man to third here as he puts this one down. And the off-balance throw gets him. Nice play for the out.
You can't ask for anything more than that. The tying run moves over to third now with only one out. So we'll see how the infield decides to play it here.
Digging in now for Philadelphia, Gene Segura, as he's got a chance to tie this ball game up with that equalizing run just 90 feet away at third. Here comes the first pitch.
Ball.
Drops to the hitter right there for laying off with a guy on third. You want to be aggressive, but you have to get a pitch you can drive.
Turned on, but that's ripped foul down the third baseline. A man at third with one away. Segura behind on a 1-2 count. Two strikes. This is on the ground over the first. Look to Bumgarner covering as he hustles over to record the out.
Up next to Philadelphia, the third baseman, Justin Turner.
So a runner at third, two men are out, and digging in at the plate will be Justin Turner. Hold the lead. Here's the delivery.
Ball.
Now a 58-foot curveball that misses for a ball. It's a high fly ball headed for the left field corner. If it stays fair, it's gone. And that nearly would have gotten him on the board. Instead, it's a long foul ball. Ready with the 1-1.
Two balls, one strike.
Men on third with two down. Grounded back up the middle. And a base hit, a good at-bat there as the Phillies have come back to tie the ball game.
Boy, there are big RBIs and big base hits, D-Row, but none more than with two outs. A big two-out knock right there. Not only ties things up, but keeps the inning going as well.
Yeah, just a great approach right there by the batter. You never know when your number's going to be called. You always want the fast of the time for the next guy behind you. Take the donut off your bat and trust in the teammate behind you. That is a huge knock and keeps the line moving.
He'll get there in plenty of time to put this one away, and that ends the inning. So a run on two hits, no errors, and a man left. Top of the order due up in the home half of the sixth, all tied at 1-1. Bottom of the inning now. Coming forward, the veteran outfielder, Starling Marte. First offering on its way. There's a breaking ball, but it doesn't quite find the strike zone. Now some movement out in the Phillies' bullpen as a lefty and a right-hander start to loosen. The 1-0. Swing and a ground ball to third. He's got it. Throws in time, and that's out number one.
Number seven.
Peralta.
Riding in once again, David Peralta. He steps in off a base hit in his last at-bat. Ready to deliver, here's the first pitch. This is on the outside corner for strike one.
Hey, this isn't exactly the way you'd like to draw it up. Not throwing a lot of first pitch strikes, but the bottom line is he's getting outs.
And it's quickly 0-2. Bases are empty, one man in. Tries the slider to ring him up, but he lays off 1-2. Still a ball and two strikes. Count still at 1-2. Ball and two strikes from Zach Wheeler. And a splitter swung on and missed that time, and that'll be out number two.
Well, pitching domination continues. Just a total of two runs on the board. So both of these starters should feel really good about their showings. If you love good pitching, this has been the game for you.
Eduardo Escobar standing in. Left-handed here as he takes a look at strike one. 0-2 for him to this point. Hit back up the middle. There's Segura. Throw in time and the side is retired. Diamondbacks down in order. Score remains deadlocked at one. Bryce Harper now, and guys, seventh inning already. Hey, I'm not complaining, but this one's been flying by.
Yeah, I'll agree with that, Matt. That's what you get when both starting pitchers have it working. Neither of them have been nibbling around the strike zone at all, and they've trusted their defense to make the plays, and they've done just that.
Yeah, and it's resulting in a game that could really go either way in these late innings. No balls and a strike to count. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Fouled away. Ball. And on 0-2, he misses with a fastball. Fastball swung on and missed as they set him down for the second time here tonight.
That's a pretty unique pitch sequence, guys. Usually pitching is all about mixing pitches and location, but he threw that all out the window to get that strikeout. He offered the same pitch three times in a row, so I guess he sort of used that reverse psychology to outthink his opponent.
So the next hitter to dig in will be Andrew McCutchen. Bumgarner gets ahead of him with strike one. He's 0-2 in the ballgame so far. Bumgarner ready with the 0-1. Fastball swung on and missed.
There's another pitch for a strike, and this guy's really attacking hitters well tonight, being aggressive early on, and if he continues to throw strikes like he is, he's going to have a pretty good night.
Count moves to a ball and two strikes now. The 1-2. Fouled off. One out, nobody on. And it misses 2-2.
Keep in mind, people, the longer the at bat, the higher the likelihood that this becomes his last inning.
Two and two is a changeup that misses 3-2. And through 6 1/3, he's about to hit the 100 pitch mark now.
Hey, you know, Matty B, this is all you can ask for as a manager in today's game of baseball. Very rarely do we see guys get through the seventh inning, so he's through the sixth here with one out, and Mark DeRosa, so far so good, a pretty decent outing.
Yeah, and I think it's going to be batter to batter here for the manager if he's going to continue to ride this hot hand or if he's going to go to the bullpen.
And here's a first pitch curveball that bounces on him there. It's ball one.
Well, he's thrown a lot of pitches in this one, but it's not like he's walking a bunch of guys. Only one free pass to this point, but they're still making him work really hard.
Maybe trying to back him up a bit there with the fastball.
Maybe a bit of an overthrow there, guys. May have let that front side open up a little early to try to pump up on a fastball and sailed on it.
2-1 after the foul ball there. The pitch. A swing and a shot hit down the corner. And that nearly broke our tie, but instead it's a foul ball. Here now the 2-2. Looked at and the count moves full.
Well, all of the umpires in the seats thought that was strike three, and they weren't far off, but I think that was a good call. Looked to be just a bit outside.
And he lays off ball four. Now the potential go-ahead run is on base here.
And when your pitch count gets over 100, you've got to expect them to lose a little bit of accuracy out there. I think if he gets in any more trouble, they might come get him. We'll see if he can finish strong.
So striding forward now, Morgan Forsythe. He was a ground out victim last time up.
Yeah, Matty, and it looked like a sinker in his last AB that got him to roll over. Kind of similar situation right here. Similar stuff on the mound. Look for them to try and get him to do exactly the same thing as his last AB. He's got to fight to get it elevated just a little bit more.
Still tied, one apiece. Now the skipper's on his way out toward the home plate area, and I believe that means we're going to have a double switch here. Francisco Liriano will come on now, and he'll slide into the seventh spot in the lineup following the double switch. Scott Kingery is into the ball game as well, as he'll slide into the pitcher's spot, hitting ninth now on the double switch. First offering on its way. Fastball taken, but that gets the zone for a strike. And he lays off for ball one. Here's the 1-1 pitch. And here's a fastball, not close, as he runs it to 2-1 now. Here's the pitch.
No, that's down.
Every base runner in a close game like this really matters, so you can't afford to be giving out free passes this late.
And he lays off ball four. Now the potential go-ahead run is on base here.
And that's what you want from your leadoff hitter. Show some great patience in this one, making the pitcher labor to start the game. The result is a leadoff walk and a chance to make some early noise.
Trying to pick things up where we left off.
We heard this guy's a good fastball there. He got a fastball and didn't miss it. Let's see if they pitch him a little bit differently this time and mix in some off-speed pitches.
And it's fouled away. Set and the 0-1. And the slider's in the dirt as he lays off it for a ball. Pitch taken several inches below the zone, in fact.
Sometimes you got to be aggressive offensively, but sometimes you just let the pitcher dig his own grave. Patience and discipline seem to be the way to go right here.
Back up the middle and in for a base hit. Throw will hold him at second, but the go-ahead runs in scoring position now with still nobody out.
Nice piece of hitting right there. Didn't try and do too much. Fastball middle cut, places it right back where it came.
Stepping in now, Carson Kelly, as he takes a called strike on the black. It's 0-1. Mariano, a 36-year-old veteran, is a 15-year major league vet, so it's been quite the career for him.
Yeah, Matty, to play 14 years in the big leagues, without question, I can't tell you what this guy's seen. Add in the minor league stops, he's seen every corner of this nation right here. He's been on buses, he's been on charter planes, he's seen every part of what baseball has to offer.
Protecting on 0-2, so we'll do it again. Nothing in two count, and the pitch. On the line, that's a base hit. And the go-ahead run will move up to third, and wisely hold there with nobody out.
Boy, there's a full of base hit right there.
Yeah, you have to play the game right there and respect the infield and respect the line drive. I know he wants to get a ribby for his buddy, but that's the way the game's played.
First pitch coming, here it is. Sends that one out of play for strike one.
Pitcher on the mound has to find a way to minimize damage right here. Gotta believe he's willing to trade two outs for a run.
Bases loaded here, nobody out. Another one fouled off, and he's quickly behind 0-2. Hit to third. Turner's got it. A tag for one. On to first, and they get the double play. Coming to the plate now, Nick Ahmed. Runner in scoring position with Sukan. Indication from the dugout that they'll issue the free pass, and with the pitcher on deck, that will force their hand here with two gone. Zach Eflin is over pitching duties, looking to get that final out now here in this seventh inning.
Your attention, please. Now pitching for Philadelphia, number 56, Zach Eflin.
Ketel Marte will grab a bat and hit for the pitcher. Fastball just misses. That's ball one. Head to head at the start of play against Zach Eflin. He's got a 3-for-5 line. He also has one home run. Ready with the 1-0.
That pitch looked like it could have been a little high, but he's been calling that pitch all night. Kind of rough for a pinch hitter, but I'm sure his teammates let him know that's where the zone has been.
Fastball over the outside, but in there for a strike. Marte stands 6-1 and hits from both sides of the plate. This is his sixth season for him in the big leagues. 1-2 pitch. Left side, but well fouled. Two down, runners at first and second. Lays off 2-2 now.
This is a fun guy to watch. He's up and really battles. Doesn't take any pitches off. He's a grinder. Always seems to make it difficult on the opposing pitcher.
He's set. And the 2-2. Changes up on him, but that's in the dirt for the ball.
I don't think he can afford another base runner here, so whatever pitch he feels best about, whichever one he feels most comfortable with, that's the one I expect him to turn to.
Eighth pitch of the at-bat coming up. This is lined to left. McCutchen is there, and he'll make the catch to retire the side. Only one in the inning for Arizona. We'll look ahead to inning number 8 now. D-backs out in front, 2-1. Tom Garland has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the 8th. Digging in, Zach Collins. He'll try to follow up the double in his last at-bat with another big hit right here.
Well, he got a good pitch to hit last time up. Looked for it up in the zone and didn't miss it. Those are the pitches you only get. Maybe once an AB, maybe once a game, maybe once a week. So he certainly capitalized on that last time.
Strike one to start the at-bat. Wind up and the 0-1. Rolled slowly to first. Scooped up. Throw on to first in time, so the leadoff man is set down to open up inning number 8. Here's a look at the final line for the Arizona starter. He was on point from the get-go this evening.
Matty B, really a solid performance. 7 strong innings pitched, in line for the win. Needs some help for the bullpen to close this one out.
And in steps Scott Kingery. As he will take strike one on the fastball here. No balls in the strike. And he's getting his first plate appearance here in the 8th after entering off the bench just a little bit ago. Sets the target low here and it misses 1-1. Now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. Hits are now even at 4 apiece. No offer on that one. 2 balls and a strike. The 2-1 home. Takes a pass and misses that strike two.
You know, from a hitter's perspective, you get pounded in, and then he throws a nasty changeup away. Is the mindset to tell yourself that he's going to go in and out all day long, or is he going to double up? That's the cat and mouse we're seeing right now.
And look out, as that one ran in and got him.
Wow, you never want the tying run on base, especially that way. Looked like he lost his release point and the ball ran inside until it caught him. Now we'll see if he can work around it.
So the batting order turns over now and set to go Gene Segura. No hits in 3 tries so far. He struck out once. First offering on its way. Now a fastball that couldn't quite find the zone. It's ball one.
1-0.
One and one to count. pop it up on the right side of the infield. Walker has a play and hauls it in without any trouble, and they're on two away. Stepping up now, Justin Turner. From the stretch, here's the pitch.
Inside.
This is why I love having athleticism and speed on your team. You can tell the runner on first base is certainly messing with the mechanics of the pitcher.
The pitcher's duel continues here. 2-1 score as we play the eighth. High in the air down the right field line. But this will land untouched. The 2-1 bounce towards the second baseman. Throw on to first, and that error won't come back to haunt them after all as the inning is over. Phillies strand one. Our score remains 2-1. One to the D-backs leadoff man. And he pumps the fastball by him here. 1-2 now. Here it comes. So two balls and two strikes now. And a 3-2 full count to Starling Marte.
Everything this guy throws moves. That two-seamer has a mind of its own.
Down the first baseline. Hoskins has it. And he'll take it to the bag. Ready now for the Diamondbacks. David Peralta, he went down on strikes last time up. First pitch of the at bat. Changed up on him and dropped it in for a called strike. Bases are empty, one man in. Tried to pull that one back, but he couldn't do it, and it's 0-2 now. Got him swinging. Chased it well out of the zone, and there are two gone.
It's so hard to hit when you're behind the count 0-2, right? You have to protect your fastball. You have to look for the soft stuff down and away. You're really at a disadvantage when you fall behind 0-2.
At the plate now, Eduardo Escobar. As the first pitch to him is in there for a called strike one. He could really use a knock here, 0-for-3 in the game so far. Oh, and one count and the pitch.
Ball.
He didn't look overly pulled right there because a lot of pitchers will go to the breaking stuff 0-2, but he certainly looked ready for a breaker on that pitch.
High in the air down the right field line. And 8 innings have come and gone now as the inning is over. So 1-2-3 go the Diamondbacks. They still lead it 2-1. Ken Giles comes on from the pen, hoping to finish this one off here in the top of the ninth.
Almost went deep his last AB, certainly just missed it. With this guy's big power, he's feeling pretty good at the dish. Look for him to try and get on something and drive it out of the yard this AB.
That's yanked into the stands, strike one. Fastball well outside. One. There's a swing and a high deep drive headed for the right field corner. And a big sigh of relief on the mound as that nearly tied it, but this ball is foul. This one off. Here's the 1-2. There's a fastball well off the plate inside. Fouled away. Again, he sends it out of play. He's set. Here's the 2-2. So long, he's finally set down here after an 8-pitch at bat. Leadoff man gone to start at the top of the ninth as we take a look at lead saves leaders entering play. And as you see there, he finds himself in sixth place in the category in the National League. Stepping up to the plate, Bryce Harper. He'll look to bounce back after striking out his last time up.
Yeah, and kind of shocked he got blown away with a fastball. You could tell he was late on that one. And we'll see if he tries to cheat to something this AB.
Slaps that one away and the count will be nothing and one.
It's going to be back to some serious tee work if he can't put that pitch in play right in his wheelhouse.
0-1, the count to Bryce Harper. One run game here in the top of the ninth. Try and tempt him with one in the dirt, but he'll hold back here. It's 1-2. And he struck out again. That's the third time he's gone down on strikes in this one.
Well, you have to feel pretty confident about the way this one's going to end up as a manager. Two hitters, two strikeouts from the closer. There's not a whole lot more he can do to instill confidence that he's going to wrap this thing up without any problem.
Phillies down to their final out now. And that'll bring up the former National League MVP, Andrew McCutchen. He's set and the pitch. Strike called in the upper part of the zone. The victory will belong to Madison Bumgarner, barring any late turn of events here. two out, nobody on. Popped him up. Escobar has room in foul territory. That's the ball game.
Yeah, they just keep on keeping on. Got a nice little run going here, winning four in a row and playing with a lot of confidence. Success is never guaranteed in this game, so you have to appreciate it when it comes.
Close one tonight, 2-1 the final score. The Arizona Diamondbacks jumped ahead in the seventh inning and never gave the lead back. Madison Bumgarner earns his eighth victory of the season. Ken Giles hammers down the save, his 28th on the season. So that just about does it for Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew. I'm Matt Baskirgin. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to theshownation.com.